Hettingen. I'm with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service's New England Field Office, Ecological Services. I'm an endangered species biologist.
And I'm John Reichard. I'm the National Assistant Coordinator for White Nose Syndrome with U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, based in the Hadley, Massachusetts office.
We're here in Charlestown, New Hampshire, at a barn that we've been trapping for about 5 years. We missed 1 or 2 years in between, so maybe we have 3 or 4 years of trapping little brown bats and banding them to determine if we've got survivors, if we can recapture bats that we've banded in years past.
This is a really exciting colony to be visiting in 2016.
Yep.
We are pretty close to Aeolus Cave, which is one of the largest hibernacula in the Northeast. So with the severe impacts from white nose syndrome that we saw at Aeolus Cave, with declines from the counted bats there estimated to be very, very high for little brown bats, now that we have remaining summer colonies of this species, it's particularly exciting, in my opinion, to see them bats here that have survived multiple years, likely being infected or exposed to BD each winter. Some of the important questions that we ask about colonies like this is, how long are bats surviving? Do they continue to be exposed each year to disease? Are they reproducing at rates that are similar to what we understand they had, the species had prior to white nose syndrome? And we use all of that information to get a better sense of whether this is a colony that has potential to persist and even proliferate into the future. Something about these bats, whether it happens in the winter or in the summertime, is helping them through the disease, through the impacts of the disease.
So tonight we set up 2 harp traps. Those are traps with bands of very thin monofilament strings that are set apart so that the bat can fly. It notes the first band of strings, kind of like this, it's offset, flies through, turns sideways, and then hits the second one and drops into a bag. So it's a very easy way to capture bats. I think our bats have learned about the harp traps, so we're not capturing as many as we have in years past. But what we've been doing is capturing them up at the top of the barn where they're roosting, and then we bring them down and we weigh them, we measure their arms, we determine whether it's an adult or a juvenile, male or female, or whether the female is lactating, you know, still nursing a pup or post-lactating, no longer nursing. And we've seen reproduction, we've seen flying pups, and we've also seen pups attached to the mothers. Very young ones, so they're in all different stages of reproduction right now. So it looks like that's a good healthy sign. Certainly the bats look healthy. Some do look like they've had wing damage, maybe from white nose syndrome, maybe not. But certainly it's healed, and they look good. Weights look good, and it's just great to see them.